sudden acceleration. Has it happened to you? What would it sound like? Something like this. Sudden acceleration claims are most often characterized by automatic transmission cars almost exclusively, older people over the age of 45 or 50, more so than not women, cars that with low mileage like this one, or rarely used or new to the driver. Also, within a few minutes of starting the car or within a few seconds, you've got the car and you put it in reverse. As well, upon investigation after an accident, if there is one, the car will never show its defect, and there are no known examples of the car to compare it to. And on subsequent investigations, you won't find any defects there as well. That's what characterizes a sudden unintended acceleration claim: lack of evidence and a people profile. Sudden acceleration is a phenomena of human behavior. It is not a problem with a car. That is to say, it's not exactly a car part problem. Perhaps they could design better cars so they fit us better. But if you're one of these people that think there are cars that accelerate by themselves, they don't. There's no such thing. It's Hollywood legend, and that's it. There's never been a reported case where a car automatically floored itself and lost its brakes. This is how it happens. Most people have their foot like I do on the brake, and they move it over to the gas like that. You see, the foot's on an angle. It's very close to the brake. And when I'm stepping on it, you can see here that I'm still touching the accelerator. Most people's pedals are worn just on the edge here. You can see that. And that's because we're not stopping our cars like this, which is a little unusual angle for your foot to be at. But I mean, the brake pedal's even perfectly perpendicular to your body. If you wanted to step on it fully, that's how you do it. But nobody does that. We all drive like this. Driving like this can be a problem because sudden acceleration claims, this is what happened. People actually touch the accelerator and the gas at the same time. And if you got your foot more on the gas than you do the brake, this happens. Right there, the car decided to accelerate until I pushed on the brake more. So I would claim after the fact that yes, I did have my foot on the brake. I remember quite clearly pushing the brake. It just didn't work. Well, it was working. It's just that its effectiveness is severely diminished when you've got your foot on the gas. I'll demonstrate that one more time. Here we go, driving along. And you have to brake suddenly. You heard the ABS kick in because the tires are spinning because I was actually accelerating. That's sudden acceleration. This problem with the angled foot, you can see there's hardly any distance, and my foot's not big. It's only a size 8 shoe. And it's a dress shoe, so it's not a boot. It's rather narrow. And I can still, quite easily, without even trying very hard, whoops, step on both. And even there, so I made a bit of a mistake and stepped a bit too hard, and I didn't want to. Now, of course, your foot can slip right off the gas pedal. It's quite easy to do, especially that edge right there wears. And that's a problem. And you'll see almost everybody's brake pedal worn on that edge. I've never seen a brake pedal worn on this side or worn out in the middle. Never. So the pedal design has to be changed if it's going to stop us from doing this. Certainly the pedals could be further apart. Now, one way to fix this problem is to learn how to drive with 2 feet. This is a quick fix. Some people are going to say, oh, that's not the right thing to do. But if you can train your brain to drive with 2 feet, then in a chance of an accident, this should happen. 2 feet go down on two pedals, and you can't miss the brake with one of your feet. All you've got to do is train yourself to drive with 2 feet. That would be a simple solution, so people could change their behavior and we could fix this problem. If you can learn to drive with 2 feet, it's an easy enough thing to do. People drive with 2 feet with manual transmissions. I don't see any reason why we can't do it with automatics, because sudden acceleration is a complaint with automatic cars only. And the reason is, we don't use 2 feet. But if we start using 2 feet to drive, these sudden acceleration complaints will go away, accidents will diminish or disappear, and nobody needs to die. All we have to do is train ourselves to drive with the left foot. It's not that hard. Lots of taxi drivers do it. This is unintended acceleration. Got the car going backwards very quickly. And I just put it in gear. Haven't touched the accelerator. Okay, I'm just gonna see how fast this car can go. And then you can see down there, there's my foot. There's no gas pedal action right there. Not at all. My car's actually in second gear now. It's a little over 1,000 RPM. You see the right side. And the car just changed into another gear. Now it's picking up speed. We are going down a slight hill. And again, without touching the gas pedal, there's my foot. This car is going approximately 20 miles an hour, and Canadian, that's about 40. Let's see how far this goes. We actually have gotten up to 40 kilometers an hour. And now I have my foot back on the gas, and away we go. Back into the driveway where we came from. And now we'll see how far the car goes with my foot on the gas. RPM's down even lower now. It's down to about 600 or so. Right there, you can see it, the gauge on the right-hand side. I'll take my foot off the gas, and we'll see how fast this car goes now. It doesn't go very fast once it's warmed up. Maybe 5 miles an hour on level ground. That's unintended acceleration.